In the beginning was the Word. And the Word was with God. And the Word was God. The Word became flesh and dwelt among us. This is the symphony of Christmas. Since the fall of man in the Garden of Eden, sin has separated all of us from the holiness of God. For centuries, the payment for the penalty of sin was through a blood sacrifice. Countless innocent lambs were slain in an attempt to maintain righteousness before God. However, our Heavenly Father had a master plan. He chose to send His one and only Son, Jesus, to give His life as the final payment for all sin. And so, after 400 years of silence between God and His people, He sent a messenger to a chosen one, a young virgin girl named Mary.
Greetings, O favored one, the Lord God is with you. Do not be afraid, for you have found
words, but her betrothed husband, Joseph, was troubled by the news. He made plans to quietly end his engagement to Mary, but an angel appeared to him in a dream, saying, "Fear not, for that which is conceived in Mary is of the Holy Spirit. She will bear a son, and you shall call his name Jesus, for he will save his people from their sins." And it came to pass that a decree went out that the whole Roman Empire should be registered. Joseph took Mary and began the wearisome journey to the town of his ancestors, Bethlehem. Found a town overwhelmed with people, and they could find no place to stay. Mary knew the time to deliver the baby was near, so Joseph pleaded with an innkeeper who offered them shelter in his stables. There, in the presence of lowly cattle and sheep, Mary gave birth to Jesus. The King of Heaven, who could have come in regal robes on a mighty horse surrounded by angelic armies, chose to come softly, sweetly, as a newborn baby lying in a manger. Quiet stillness blanketed the town. The streets were empty. The marketplace sat dormant. And on the outskirts of town, shepherds kept a sleepy but watchful eye on their flocks. A gentle breeze drifted through the fields underneath a velvet sky as time almost seemed to stand still. Suddenly, the calm was broken by an immense light. As an angel of the Lord burst forth from the heavens with a proclamation. Do not be afraid, for behold, I bring good news of great joy, which shall be for all the world. Today, in the town of David, a Savior has been born. A Savior who is Christ the Lord. Now you must go and find him. Look for a baby wrapped in swaddling clothes, lying in a manger. All at once, the skies were consumed by a massive choir of angels as their voices rang out in triumphant praise. The shepherds did as the angel told them, and they found the Christ child lying in the manger. They shared the news with all who would hear, and they came to worship.
Angels weep.
The people who walked in darkness have seen a great light. To those who dwelt in a land of deep darkness, new light has dawned. For unto us a child is born, unto us a son is given. And his name shall be called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, the Everlasting Father, the Prince of Peace, and of his kingdom there shall be no end. A great star rose over the place where Jesus was born. It led three wise men from the east to come and worship.
Christ the Lord, the newborn.
mountain's ends, for the Lord above all lords. Myrrh, for the sacrifice to end all sacrifices. Gold, for the king above all kings.